it seems to me that above all people, the most disturbed people can't handle medication intrusions into their lives. It's like the reverse of what psychiatry says. I mean, sometimes I kid and they say, well, if you want to drug somebody, you know, drug some powerful attorney who's manipulating his family and brutalizing his wife, and maybe it'll slow him down, give everybody else a chance, you know, okay. But I don't really mean that, of course. But the last person that you want to drug or to tell that they have a biological disorder is a 17-year-old girl who doesn't know if she's the Virgin Mary or if she's a prostitute or whether she's good or evil, and whether her mother has a tail and her father has horns, and who's terrified and frightened. That person needs such gentleness and patience and understanding and relationship. That human being really needs to be cared for in every thing that word means. And so what we do instead is to brutalize. My colleagues have it all backward in psychiatry. They think it begins with a biochemical imbalance in the brain. But actually, when you get to know people who are depressed, they have depressing lives. They're stuck in marriages they don't want, or they're stuck in jobs they don't want, or they haven't resolved terrible problems from childhood. Many, many people who have these long-term depressions they can't escape from their childhood. And those are the cases probably the most that need some sort of intensive counseling. But the contest is not between drugs, counseling, between Prozac and Peter Breggin's therapy. The context is between drugs and life, all of life. When you take a drug, it dulls your spirits or it gives you an artificial high. That's about all the antidepressants can do. So you get a little elated for a while, but that's fake. That's biochemical. That's got nothing to do with life. Or you get anesthetized, you get apathetic. You don't feel your pain as much. You've been anesthetized spiritually. You end up locked into place where you were before because your creative energies, your choices, they're not there anymore. And on top of it, because your neurotransmitters have been disrupted, you can't quite think with the same sharpness and the same feeling that you used to have. Unlike a lot of other things in psychiatry, depression is among the easiest to treat. The single most important thing in helping somebody who's depressed is for you not to be depressed. Now, that's a tough standard for a lot of psychiatrists, because what are they doing to their patients? They're drugging them. They're diagnosing them. They're not really involved with them and caring about them. Most psychiatrists have depressing lives. You go to the psychiatrist and you say, I feel hopeless and helpless. And the doctor says, in effect, well, yes, you are. You're controlled by your biochemicals. How depressing. I mean, for a moment, it might feel better, like, oh, I don't have to do the work of facing my life. But in the long run, the worst message you can give a human being is to tell them their psychological and spiritual problems are biochemical disorders or diseases, because it disempowers them. They don't know where to look. They don't know what conflicts to even deal with.